In this video, we will show you how to create and duplicate pages in WeWeb and how to protect them based on whether a user is authenticated or what role they have or don't have. I have the design of my web app in Figma, which I analyzed to identify what pages I needed to create in my front end. So I decided I needed to create one page with a list of the current user's tickets, which would be private, a page for each ticket details, a page to create a new ticket, and a page for admins only with a list of all the tickets of all users, and a page again for admins only where I could change the roles and permissions of users. And finally, I need a login page so that people can authenticate, and this is what will allow me to make all those other pages private. So in WeWeb, I created a login page when I set up authentication. The private access is set to everybody. Everybody can access the login page. And when a user logs in, I will redirect them to a private page called My Tickets. So we have the user's tickets page already. Then we have a page with the details of a ticket. So let's create that page. And we will add a variable, which will be the ID of the ticket. This empty page. And we'll protect it. Then we will want a page to create new tickets. So let's add a page. We will make this private. All tickets. We will make this private and create an admin role and admin user group. In a dedicated video, we will show you how to work with these roles. For now, let's make sure to protect our all tickets page here. There we go. Our permissions page. And that's it. We have all our pages. Now let's show you a couple of pro tips that you may or may not need depending on your use case. First, when you create a page, you have the option to copy it from an existing page. So that can be useful at times. And second, if you have a lot of pages and private and public and different roles, it can help in your Miro or wherever you listed the pages that you need to create to have some sort of visual cue to let you know that you've done this. So it could be changing the background color of your post-it to green. It could be adding a check mark of sorts to say, okay, you've done this. Whatever works for you, but when working on a very large project, it can really help to document what you've already done. That way you don't forget anything by mistake. That's it. That's how you create pages in WeWeb and restrict access to pages based on a user's authentication status and the user groups they're part of.